lain kali aku bikin cerita bohongan juga.
Patricia Agatha.
Good morning everybody and dear judge. Before I start, I want to introduce myself. My name is Patricia Agatha Chintaka Putri. I'm from 11, Science and Mathematics of 5. Today, I want to read a story about Asian Puddle, the real version of Cinderella by Brothers Grimm. A wealthy gentleman's wife lay on her deathbed and called her only daughter to her bedside. She asked her to remain good and kind and told her that God will protect her. She then died and was buried. A year one day, and the widower married another woman who had two daughters of her own. They had beautiful faces and fair skin, but their hearts were cruel and weak. The stepsister stole the girl's fine clothes and jewels and forced her to wear rags. They banished her in the kitchen to the worst course and gave her the nickname Asian Puddle or Ashu in English. Despite all of this, the girl remained good and kind, and would always go to her mother's grave to cry and pray to God that she would see her circumstance improve. One day, the gentleman visited a fair, promising his stepdaughter's gifts of luxury. The eldest asked for beautiful dresses, while the younger for pearls and diamonds. His own daughter merely asked for the first twig to knock his head off on the way. The gentleman went on his way and accused presents for his stepdaughters. While passing a forest, he got a hazel twig and gave it to his daughter. She planted the twig over her mother's grave, watered it into her tears, and over the years, it grew into a glowing hazel tree. The girl would pray under it 3 times a day, and the white bird would always come to life for her. The king decided to give a festival that would last for 3 whole days and nights, and invited all the beautiful maidens in the land to attend so that the prince could select one of them as his bride. The two sisters were also invited, but when Asian Puddle or Cinderella begged them to allow her to go with them into the celebration, the stepmother refused because she had no dress and no shoes to wear. When the girl insisted, the woman threw a dish of lentils into the ashes for her to pick up, guaranteeing her permission to attend the festival, and when the girl accomplished the task in less than an hour with the help of 2 white doves sent by her mother from heaven. The stepmother only redoubled the task and threw down even a greater quantity of lentils. When Asian Puddle was ordered to accomplish in a great speed, not wanting to spoil her daughter's age, the stepmother hastened away with the ball and left her crying stepdaughter behind. The girl returned to the graveyard to ask for help. The white bird dropped a white dove and slipped
shoes.
She went to the ball and warned him that she must leave before midnight. The prince then took her, but she left him before midnight struck. Next evening, the girl appeared in a much greater gown. The prince fell in love with her and danced with her for the whole evening. But when it came, she left again. The third evening, she appeared dressed in spun gold with slippers of gold. Now the prince was determined to keep her and had the interest. And when she ran away, one of her daughters was left up on the beach. The prince proclaimed that he would marry the maiden whose foot would fit the golden slipper. The next morning, the prince went to Asian Puddle's house and tried the slipper on the eldest stepsister. The sister was advised by her mother to cut off her shoes in order to fit the slipper. While meeting with the stepsister, the two doves from heaven thought the place that blood dripped from her foot, appeared by her treasury. He went back again and tried to slip around the other sister. She cut off part of her heel in order to get her foot in the slipper, and again the prince was fooled. While reading with her to the king's castle, the dogs alert him again about her blood and her foot. He came back to inquire about another girl. The gentleman told him that they kept a kitchen met in the house, omitting to mention that she was his own daughter, and the prince asked him to let her try on the slipper. The girl appeared after washing herself, and when she put on the slipper, the prince recognized her as the stranger who told he had danced at the ball. In the end, the relationship came to Sweden as she was walking down the alley with her stepsister as her bridesmaids. They had hooked their way into her coffer. Then the dogs from heaven flew down and struck to the two sisters' eyes, one in the left and the other in the right. When reading come to an end, and Ashokata and her prince match up off the court, the dogs play again, striking the remaining eyes of two ever sisters' blood, a punishment they had to endure for the rest of their lives. I think that's all of my story. Thank you for your attention. Good morning.